Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear MGTOWs. Here is an article from the Reddit forums within the REDDCOIN section.it talks about fantasy realities of a woman, and the fantasy of a man. Explaining and comparing both one to another, we may take some lessons about these. Some points are blatant reminders of the inner nature of men, and the inner nature of women. Let's just dive in. Men and women alike are idealistic. They both view life through a fantastical lens filled with grandiose visions of where they would like to be or how they'd like their life to be. They'll often long for a better job, better house, better city or a better partner. We all want this mythical better that's out there. It's our human nature to long to improve our lives and ourselves. The key difference between female fantasy and male fantasy is that men tend to ground their fantasies with more logical truths and rational perspective. They are forced to filter them down because no one is going to perpetuate a delusion. No one is going to take responsibility for their mishaps and no one is going to take the initiative and help them along to a soft landing. Men who live in Wonderland pay the consequences for it. Women, on the other hand, are more free to live in fantasy land. There is seldom consequence for conveniently living in a perpetual state of delusion. In fact, most of the time most people will endorse their delusions. There are seldom forces that bring down their fleeting fantasies into harsh realities. This leaves women in their feelings far more attached to their fantasies than men. The ultimate female fantasy is the Uber Chad. The prince with a 12-inch dick and four-story mansion on the hills that's coming in to swoop her out of her mundane existence. She hopes that every new man she meets will turn out to be him, and if not, the closest she can get to him as possible, which is why women are quite accommodating to approaches. They want you to be that guy, they want you to be the fantasy that finally lands in her lap. Provided you pass the initial visual filters, she'll be happy to hear you out to see what you're all about. Where most guys get it horribly wrong is they murder this fantasy all too quickly and bring her crashing back down to earth. Upon meeting her, they'll overshare with scripted conversations, filling the gaps with boring details. By the end of it, they've painted a picture that's anything but magical. Her hopeful flame withers away and she loses interest. She realizes they're just as average as the 200 guys that's come along before them. Naturally, she moves on to the next guy, hoping that maybe he will be the one to fulfill the fantasy. The guy who profits most out of his encounters with women is the guy who's able to feed the fantasy better than anyone else. The guy who keeps her in a state of wonder, excitement and mystery. The guy who conveys an interesting life and job, but more importantly, the guy who knows how to appeal to her idealistic nature. You do this not by oversharing every little detail of your natural-born life, but by letting her in on only the juicy bits while letting her hamster do the most of the work. The unknown is food for her hamster. What she doesn't know about you, she'll fill in with the most idealistic, interesting version of you possible. Fantasy is a woman's default setting. Keep your job a mystery and she'll fantasize about you doing some high-level, important swindling. Keep what you do with the other women in your life a mystery and she assumes you're having routine orgies every week. Keep how you spend your time a mystery and she assumes you're doing some epic, thrilling activities. She can't help herself but to let her mind run to idealism. You do, however, need to assist her in building fantasies. Let her in on the most interesting snippets of yourself. Tell her about that pilot's license you have, the dancing class you give, the three countries you went to last year or that deep sea diving trip you just got back from. Tell her all the wonderful exciting things that she can build her fantasies around. She'll quickly construct a picture that appears to be quite exciting, filling in the blanks with her hopes and dreams. Leave out all the boring pleasantries that most guys love talking about. If your job is boring as shit, don't talk about it, or at least make it sound interesting. If you have no particularly interesting hobbies to build off, then you actually are pretty boring and it's no wonder women aren't too amazed by you. Leave out the common self-deprecating lines that guys seem to think is cute these days. It really isn't. Let her take the journey and figure out things for herself. In reality, no man is really the superhuman twat she dreams about, but that won't stop her from fantasizing about you being him. Use this tool, feed her arousal and let her hamster do most of the work for you. Be mysterious, ambitious, vague and exciting, giving her just enough that she knows you're interesting, but not enough to know your story. You'll find her own mind takes her to more interesting places than you ever could.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.